Today on Amplified, I'm going to start designing the subwoofer enclosure for the Mule. This episode of Amplified is brought to you by GoDaddy. When I design a subwoofer enclosure, I like to start by building. Call me crazy, that's just how I do it. I like to cut a couple pieces of wood and see what my maximum airspace I could possibly get out of my designated area.
Well, we gotta cut a bottom, because it needs a bottom.
I'm gonna cut the top a little long because there's gonna be an angle on here, and I don't know what the angle is yet. I don't have a computer design program. We don't design our boxes with computers like f***ies over here. We do it with a goddamn tape measure and a pencil. We're gonna go 16 and a half eight. Y'all have your computer design cut sheets. I got a goddamn pencil and a paper. My goal is to build the box as big as I possibly can, see how much volume I have inside the box. We need to see how much airspace we have in there. Then we're gonna use that space to extrapolate every last bit of bass out of this woofer as we possibly can.
We're just gonna go all the way with it. We're just gonna go all the way with the bottom and the bottom to bottom. 20 deuce and a deuce half. We got a deuce half on the boost. Okay, then we're gonna might as well make our back. Might as well give it a backyotomy.
Top of the penis. So we gotta cut the tip off and circumcise it. The woofer we're using is a JL Audio 8-inch W7 Signature Series Limited Edition Bad Boy Damn. This woofer's autographed and numbered by Lucio Peroni himself, which is one of the founders of JL Audio. So to me, this is a historical little woofer. It has sentimental value to my heart, my little tiny pea heart. This is a nice historical woofer to go with our discontinued Macintosh amp, which is also historical and rare, which goes along good with this hacked up historical piece of shit. So this is gonna be a Volkswagen mini truck car audio relic from the past, which will never work right, ever. I like to build my subwoofer boxes out of 3/4 inch birch because it's lightweight and it sounds exactly 0.4% better than MDF. You have to be careful with birch. You can't slide your hands across the edges like you can with MDF because you're gonna splinter the shit out of yourself looking like you got in a slap fight with a damn porcupine. MDF is a lot easier to work with, but it contains urea formaldehyde, which is a carcinogen. It's cancerous, it can irritate your eyeballs, it can get into your ears and your lungs. It's a dusty fucking cancerous mess. But here we chose to use birch. This is P2 carbureted birch, which is low on the formaldehyde list. It's environmentally friendly, and I like it. It feels nice. I like using birch for my boxes because you can feel the life from the tree. When you're bumping your sub in a birch box, you can feel the soul of the tree, man. I'm telling you, you gotta try it. So you can choose to build your box between the magical, perfect MDF fiberboard that emits cancerous dust, or you can get the more expensive, splintering asshole of all woods, birch, which might sound a little bit better. So those are some things to weigh out when you're choosing your material, and son of a birch, I'll take the birch. But ultimately, for your car, the choice is yours, so I don't give a fuck what you think about my choice, nor do I give a shit about your damn choice. So let's just leave that comment box empty for once in your damn life and move the fuck on. If If I make this box as big as I can possibly make it, I have 3 cubic feet to work with. Exactly, right on the damn money.
See, old laptops, they got a butthole on the back. You gotta put it in the butthole.
So I'm going to open up a Windows application called Win ISD Pro. This is a free app that'll let me input the parameters of my woofer, as well as the dimensions of the supposed box I'm going to build, and it'll give me a plot out of what it's going to sound like. It's magical. It'll show me what it's going to sound like without even building it. However, some boxes that look good on paper still sound like boo-boo, so you always got to leave room for the ultimate fail to happen. Be willing to try again and build another box if your box sucks a dick and sounds like shit. That's all you can do. We can get as scientific as we can, but that's about all we can do. Thanks for watching Amplified. Make sure you guys go to soundmanca.com and check out our website. You'll find our iPad kits for your car up for sale over there, as well as some t-shirts and hoodies. Go check it out. Also, check out our sponsor for this episode, GoDaddy.com. Go there, they got a couple discounts for you. Use AMP295 at checkout and you're gonna get your domain name for $2.95. Go check it out. Or you could use promo code AMP30 and you're gonna get 30% off your entire order. GoDaddy has everything to get your online business up and running fast. Go check it out. We'll see you guys Thursday. Peace.